everyone, greetings from Gunjan IVF World. I am Dr. Garima Sharma, IVF consultant, gynecologist and in charge of Gunjan IVF World, Janakpuri branch. Today I will answer some most frequently questions asked about low AMH. So first question that comes into mind is, what is AMH? AMH is a hormone that is being produced by primordial cells of your ovary. So your ovary produces a hormone called AMH, which is produced by certain cells from the ovary, which are called primordial follicles. So when a girl child is born, she is born with millions of these follicles, and as she goes on, as she ages, the number of these follicles decreases. So when she reaches puberty, from the million the count becomes lakh, and from that day onwards, again every year the number of follicles decreases. So your AMH also decreases with your age. So what does AMH tells about? As AMH is produced by the primordial follicles, so it tells about your egg number, egg reserve. So if the AMH comes out to be low, it indicates that your egg reserve is less. It does not predict your chances of becoming pregnant. So if your egg number is less, if your egg reserve, that is your AMH value, comes out to be low, it does not indicate that you can't fall pregnant. You can fall pregnant, but it may take time for you to fall pregnant. So it indicates your egg number, and if you are going for IVF treatment or any fertility treatment, it indicates how your ovary will respond to the drugs or medicines that we give for IVF or your fertility treatment. So the next question that comes is, what is the normal value of AMH? The normal value of AMH is around 2 to 6.8 nanogram per ml, and low AMH, we generally say this value is less than 1.5. So if your value comes out to be less than 1.5, it means that your egg number reserve is low, and if the value comes less than 0.5, your AMH comes into very low category. But you don't need not to worry about things that if your AMH is low, you won't be able to fall pregnant at all. You can fall pregnant. The next question is, what causes low AMH? So low AMH is, the as I said, that as you age, the number of eggs decreases, your primordial follicles, antral follicle decreases. So this produces less amount of this hormone, and that's why your AMH decreases. So it is a natural process. With age, your number of eggs will decrease and your AMH will decrease. Second cause, it could be because of certain genetic issues. So if you have any chromosomal or genetic problem, like condition like galactosemia or Turner syndrome mosaic, then also you may have low AMH even at low age. So the next cause could be because of certain autoimmune conditions, your AMH can come out to be low. And it could be if you have undergone any chemotherapy or radiotherapy, because of which these egg follicles number decreased, and so your AMH value came out to be low. Conditions like endometriosis also affects your egg number, and in those cases also your AMH value may come out to be low. What are the symptoms of low AMH? Low AMH per se does not show any symptom. There may be minute some symptoms which even you may not notice. So you won't have any as such symptom in your body which will tell you that you are having low AMH. Two basic things that you can observe is, one, your cycles may become irregular. So each woman has a definite duration of cycle. Some women has a 28-day cycle, some has 30-day cycle. So if this cycle duration changes, then it can be because of low AMH. So if your cycle was earlier 20 days, it has become, now it has shortened to 15 days, or if it was earlier 25 days, it has become 20 days. This may be an indicator of a low AMH. Second symptom could be if your flow of your periods have decreased. So earlier the flow was more, and now the flow has decreased. So these are the two common symptoms that are generally observed if you are having a low AMH. your cycle duration may change or your bleeding may per se decrease. Then the question that comes into mind and people generally ask that does low AMH indicate poor quality of eggs? Practically no, the low AMH does not indicate that you have poor quality of eggs. It only shows your egg reserve, and when we are doing an IVF, it shows how our drugs, our injections will, your ovary will respond to those drugs or injections. So it is more of a quantitative analysis test. It shows about the number of eggs. It does not as such predict about your quality of egg. So there are millions of women who even with low AMH conceive. So everybody does not do an AMH test if they conceive naturally. It could be a 20-year-old lady who have an AMH of 1.2, and if she conceive within 1 year of marriage, she won't get her AMH test. So AMH, it does not actually tells about the quality of your eggs. It basically predicts it's the quantity, what is the number of your eggs that you are having, and how your body will respond to the treatment that we generally give for a conception fertility treatment. So the next question is, does low AMH causes miscarriages? So this also, the answer to this is also no. Low AMH will not cause miscarriage. The miscarriage could be because of some other reason. It could be any genetic abnormality in the embryo or any anatomical defect in your uterus which has led to miscarriage. But because of low AMH, you won't have any miscarriage. The other question is, does low AMH causes menopause? So this is actually a complex question. The low AMH does not cause menopause, but low AMH, if a woman has low AMH, so she might have early menopause because her number of eggs have decreased. When do menopause happen? So when your number of your ovaries stop producing certain hormones. These hormones are produced when you ovulate, when eggs are released from the ovary. So if eggs are not there and they are not released from the ovary, these hormones are not produced, so you won't have any periods. So when the production of these hormones stops because your ovaries have stopped producing eggs, then your periods also stops and you go into menopause. So when you are having low AMH, so your number of eggs are less, so you may have menopause early, but it does not show that, I can't predict that if you are having, if your low AMH is low, that you will have your menopause in 5 years or in 10 years. It may be that from a normal woman who will have a menopause at 50, the woman who is having low AMH may have earlier than that her menopause. But if your AMH is very low, means it is 0.5 or 0.05, in such cases, it shows that you may have menopause in coming 5 years because your ovarian reserve has decreased, your ovaries number have decreased a lot. So in coming 5 years, you may have menopause. So low AMH does not cause menopause. It may say that you may have early menopause. So one other question that I've already answered in what are the causes of low AMH is, low AMH genetically related? Yes, it is genetically related. It may be if your mother or your sister had early menopause, then also you may have a low AMH, and if there is any genetic factor or chromosomal abnormality, they can also lead to low AMH. So they were some of the frequently asked questions that I try to answer about low AMH. Any other questions that you have, you can write in the comment section. Me or my team will surely try to answer those. Thank you.